Good morning from the Nature Company. Today we're going to be going over post-fungicidal treatment care. It's something we often forget to tell you about. You treat your orchids for fungus and think everything's going to be okay. But you notice that they tend to keep dying back and your leaves start yellowing and dying off. You get brown gooey spots and you wonder, has the treatment not worked? We'll go through you step by step, show you what to do to fix this. It's part of the reason that you've done the fungicidal treatment in the first place. So let's get to it and we'll show you what's happening and how to go about rectifying the problems. Here we have an orchid that we've treated with fungicide and we see all these dead parts all over it and we're wondering, why is our orchid looking more sick now post treatment than it was before treatment? Well, one of the reasons for this is the parts of the fungus that you can see on the plant is just a very small portion of the fungus that's actually on your plant. The hypha, the connecting parts of the fungus, are inundated in through your leaves and the fungicidal treatment has killed a lot of that, and in such the parts of the leaves that were heavily infected have now died too. So you land up with these dead parts, and now with all these dead parts on your plant and they're still relatively moist and juicy from the insides of the cells, bacteria takes effect quickly. Now bacteria can kill your plant really quickly. It will just cause rot and give you that strange sweet scent of rotting plants, and this will just breed in. The first things to go will be your new fresh parts of the plant, all the buds and that will be affected first and most severely, and then it will slowly get in through to the rest of the plants and into the roots. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to remove all of these infected parts so that it takes away as much of the bacteria as possible, and then we'll treat it. So we'll just go through stripping off all the old dead and rotting portions of the plant, and then we'll go and show you how we treat it and what we treat it with. Always remember that little trick of peeling through the center of the leaf, so that when you peel it off it's easier, so that you don't break any of the little buds that form down the base here off. So bacteria especially like to proliferate when there's damaged parts of the plant, as what would happen once we've killed all the fungus, because they're after have gone in through the cells and damaged the cells, and as we've killed it the cells have died too, so leaving like wounds in the plant. This just makes it easy for the bacteria to get in. We generally try and keep the plants as dry as possible for a while post fungicidal treatment, but still we do get this happening. You'll see here again, we go along the ridge of the leaf, tear it down the center, and then it just pulls apart easily. You see how under all these layers, it's still moist and damp. This is what the bacteria love. And it's difficult to keep this dry without dehydrating your orchid too far. So this is why we need to clean off all of this. Now you notice we've even got some rot coming in here. This we're just gonna pull straight out as well. So this we just pull out. Easy as that. Try and make sure not too much of the leftover tissue is left in there. Take our secateurs, especially important when working with plants like this. Make sure they're well disinfected before the process, during the process, and after. We're just cutting off the dead tips of the leaves. Okay, you'll notice with these cuts, generally I've done them at a bit of an angle. This is just helps make the plant have a more natural look to it now that we've trimmed off all the ends, because all the leaves are pointed, so we try and keep a point to them. It just helps keep the visual appeal of the plant better. Okay. Now with all the debris, make sure you clean it off properly, dispose of it nicely, rather put it into the rubbish bin so it's taken away in the trash. Other than leave it lying around, you have all your bacteria in here and you don't want to spread it around further. Okay, you've been using your hands. Give your hands a spray. Just keeping everything nicely disinfected to make sure you're not spreading anything further. Okay, now that your plant is looking all clean and clear, we can see that any solution that we spray on it is going to get to the areas that we want it to, and that will kill any of the bacteria hiding around the areas that we need to disinfect. Okay, we can go ahead and spray. The solution we're going to use is something that's freely available. It's very cheap, inexpensive. You can get it from almost any pharmacy or chemist. A lot of the supermarkets and such will have available too. It's a hydrogen peroxide solution of 3%. This we can either use directly as it is, or we can dilute it down further. If you can only get a 5% solution, then I would suggest that you do dilute it down. I would say at least half water, half 5% solution. So that will give you a better ratio to use without damaging your plant. All we're going to do now is take our hydrogen peroxide solution. This was a 3% solution that we used, and I've diluted it down further, 1:1 with water. So all we're going to do is be spraying it, especially down around the base. Okay, but notice I'm not drenching the base. I don't really want to get the hydrogen peroxide solution into the pot itself. Some people do use it as a treatment for root rot, but it can damage the roots as much as it helps them. So I prefer to use other solutions for that, like repotting and making sure that the media is changed completely. So this is just to get rid of any of the bacteria that's now been trying to infect the plant through the damaged tissue where all the fungus has died. We're giving it a fairly good spray, allowing it to run down into the gaps between the leaves. This takes effect really, really quickly. The oxidizing effects of the hydrogen peroxide kills off the bacteria and gives our orchid a good start again post-fungicidal treatment. So we'll just let this dry out now. By the time it's dried, the peroxide solution will have done its trick and most of it will have been oxidized, and that will sort it out for the time being. I only do this hydrogen peroxide solution treatment once, immediately after I've cleaned it up, to kill any of the bacteria and the latent bacteria that is lying around on the plant. Afterwards, I go on to the garlic treatment and the ginger treatment, just to keep the plant then clear of any bacteria that might be growing. The other reason that we only use the hydrogen peroxide solution once is, other than the fact that it kills all the good bacteria and the good fungus that the plant needs, it also will slowly destroy the cells of the plant. So The first treatment is easy for the plant to overcome. It just is a quick, easy fix for the to kill the bacteria that are infecting it. It's easier for the plant to overcome this initial treatment than it is to beat out the bacteria. So let's just kill the bacteria and give the plant a better start. Thank you for watching. And if you find any of the information in this video helpful at all, please hit that like button. Share with all your friends. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. And press that notification bell. Bing bong! If you want to be notified of our upcoming videos.